Hello friends, today we will start our discussion with system transfer function. So we are going to see today system transfer function. We know that the system is characterized by a difference equation which is given as k is equal to 0 to n ak y of n minus k equals to summation k is equal to 0 to m bk x of n minus k. Now, to get the system transfer function out of this difference equation, we apply z transforms. So, I will be applying z transform on this equation. To avoid confusion, I will be taking some value for n and some value for m. It's just an assumption. Let us say that n is equal to 2 and m is equal to 2 again. It is not mandatory that n and m values should be equal. N can be greater than m or vice versa. But here in this case, I take n is equal to 2 and m is equal to 2 as well. N is called as the order of the difference equation. N is called as the order of a difference equation. So now, with this assumption, with n is equal to 2 and m is equal to 2, I'll rewrite the equation as a summation k going from 0 to 2 ak y of n minus k equals to summation k going from 0 to 2 bk x of n minus k. Then putting the value of k will lead to a0 y of n plus a1 y of n minus 1 plus a2 y of n minus 2 equals to, I'll write this over here, b0 x of n plus b1 x of n minus 1 plus b2 x of n minus 2. Now, let us apply to this equation the z transform. So, we apply z transform onto this equation. We get a0 by scaling property, yn will be converted to yz plus, because of linearity property, I will have a1 scaling property, z raised to minus 1 shifting property, y of z plus a2 z raised to minus 2 y of z equals to b0 xz plus b1 z inverse xz plus b2 z raised to minus 2 xz. Okay, so what I did is I applied z transform and I used all possible properties of z transform. The properties used is shifting property. If it is shifted by 1, then I have to multiply it by z inverse. Shifted by 2, I have to multiply it by z raised to minus 2. So that I did over here. Scaling property says that you have to bring out the constants. So I bring out the constants. And linearity property says that you have to add them individually. So we have added them. So using this, I got a new equation. So I pull out y of z out of the equation and I get a naught plus a1 z inverse plus a2 z raised to minus 2 equals to x of z into b naught plus b1 z raised to minus 1 plus b2 z raised to minus 2. Now, the definition of system transfer function is written as h of z, which is equal to output upon input. So what is our output? Y of z is our output, x of z is our input. So it says h of z says it is the ratio of output upon input, which is equal to, I brought x of z down, y of z, then I have to get this thing down. So I get here as b naught plus b1 z inverse plus b2 z raised to minus 2 divided by a0 plus a1 z inverse plus a2 z raised to minus 2. So this equation is called as a system transfer function, where we have a numerator polynomial and we have a denominator polynomial with a degree 2. Okay, so now we can use the fraction method to find the roots of this equation. And let us say we get some roots of this equation and root of the above equation, then it becomes h of z equals to y of z by x of z equals to, let us say there are certain roots that I am getting, because we have not assumed what is b0, b1, b2, then I say that I am getting z minus z1 into z minus z2, because there will be two roots because degree of polynomial is 2, and here I will get z minus p1 into z minus p2, where p1, p2, z1, z2 are the roots of numerator and denominator polynomial respectively. So this is how we normally represent a system transfer function. Thank you.